This section will provide a conceptual overview of the various element schedules and component lists. ArchiCAD's Enhanced Interactive Element Schedule provides intelligent two-way communication between the schedules and the design project, ensuring that even last-minute changes will be accurately and consistently reflected in the model and documentation. You can also export the created schedules in various file formats. By default, ArchiCAD contains some predefined schedules you can start with. These are located in the Navigator Project Map under Schedules. Element lists can contain any BIM elements and all related properties, such as the volume of an entire wall. Component lists can provide detailed information about sub-elements, such as the volume of certain skins of a composite wall. Later on, you can add these lists to the project documentation or save them as individual files, like in XLS format. First, let's use an existing schedule as an example. Open the 0.ground floor. Activate the door list in the Navigator. The schedule window opens. On the left side, formatting options are available to set up the arrangement of the fields. On the right side, you can see the schedule. Use the available zoom factors arrow to change the zoom to 150%. The list items here are exactly the same ones you created before. Thanks to the BIM concept, these lists are not only automatically updated, but you also have access to the parameters and can change them directly from the schedule as well. Beside numerical values, you can also see graphical representations of the doors. Let's see how we can customize the schedule. Click the Scheme Settings button to open the Scheme Settings dialog. Here you can modify the existing schedules as well as create new ones. The existing schedules are listed on the Schedules tab of the dialog. The door list is selected because this is what we're going to modify. On the Criteria panel, you can see the primary filter of the list. These are the elements that are filtered out of the model and displayed in the schedule with certain parameters. In our case, it's door, but you can change the criteria to any or even multiple elements. On the Fields panel, you can select any available parameters and add them to the schedule fields. You can even change the order of the fields or set summary fields as well. Select the home story and zone name parameters in the list of the general parameters with the Control or Command key pressed, and click the Add button to add them to the fields list. These are general parameters available for all BIM elements in the model. Select the height and width parameters in the window door list with the Control or Command key pressed, and click Add to add them to the fields list. These are element-specific parameters, which may vary depending on the criteria you specify. Select the zone number parameter in the schedule fields list on the right, and click Remove to remove it from the list. Remove the nominal width by height size parameter as well. Select the width parameter and drag it to the third place using the arrow icons next to its name. Drag the height below the width parameter. Drag the orientation parameter to the end of the list. Click OK. The list is automatically updated. Since the BIM elements themselves are listed in the schedule, you can change their parameters from here. For example, let's change the size of the pocket door. Select the pocket door in the schedule. Click in the width field and type 1. Click the Select on Floor Plan button. The program opens the floor plan and displays the door selected. If you look at the info box, you can see that the size already reflects the changes. Switch back to the schedule window. Sometimes, door and window schedules also contain dimensions or additional graphical elements. In ArchiCAD, you can edit the previews easily. Click the 2D symbol field of the pocket door, then click the Annotate button. A separate element preview window opens with the 2D tools available. This way, you can add any annotations, dimensions, or lines and fills. Activate the Dimension tool. Change back to the Linear Geometry method and the XY-only geometry method in the info box, and place a dimension line with the door corners picked. This dimension line will be associative. If you change the size of the door, the dimensions will follow the changes immediately. Click the OK button in the top left of the window. The dimensions appear in the schedule immediately. Let's create a schedule for the foundations. This way we can calculate the necessary amount of concrete. Right-click the element node in the navigator and select New Schedule. Select construction elements in the list. Set 01 as ID and foundation as name. Click OK. The new scheme is created in the list. Now let's add the criteria in the Criteria 1 foundation panel. Wall is automatically in the list. Click the Add button. Set element type as criteria and column as value. Set OR in the AND/OR field of the wall criteria. Click the Add button again. And set Home Story as criteria. Choose -1 foundation in the value field. In this way, both the wall and the pad foundations will be part of the schedule. Now, let's set the fields. Add the net volume and type fields from the general parameters to the schedule fields list. Move type to the top and click OK. Opening the one foundation list, we can see that it contains all elements, but we still do not know the final amount. Let's get back to the settings dialog. Click the rightmost icon at the type field in the list to activate a little flag icon. This will result in a summary by type. Click on the middle icon at the net volume field to display a sum icon. This will result in an overall sum at the end of the list. Click OK. Now the schedule shows the necessary information, but still needs some formatting. You can use the formatting tools on the left panel of the schedule window. Simply select any fields and set the font size and type, etc. Check Show Uniform Items as Single Entry to display identical items as one list row. Check the Show Headline box to insert an additional row for the element type. This will help to understand the schedule more easily. Click into the Grand Total cell and highlight its value by setting its font size to 4 mm and its font pen to red. Hide the vertical borders for the entire table by selecting Entire Schedule from the Apply Format Options to List and Separators Only from the Cell Border list. Now we will list some sub-elements, like the amount of insulation in the exterior walls. The logic is similar to the element schedules we created before. As an example, let's calculate the necessary materials for the load-bearing walls. Click Scheme Settings. And click the Create New button. In the Add Schedule Scheme dialog, select Components as Items, and type 01 as ID, and Walls as Name. Click OK. In the Criteria panel, set Wall as Element Type. Load-bearing element as structural function. And 0.ground floor as home story. Add the following fields to the schedule on the Fields panel. General parameters. Fill. Components parameters. Component type. Composite skin. Component volume. Building material parameters. Cut fill. Click OK. And check the Show Uniform Items as a Single Entry checkbox. Use the formatting options on the left and the rulers to set the right appearance. ArchiCAD contains some predefined component lists as well. Review those to get more ideas on how to use the schedules. In this chapter, you created details directly based on the model using preset manufacturer drawings. You learned how to create dimensioned element schedules and component lists. You also practiced how to change element parameters directly from the schedule window, and how to modify an existing schedule to meet your needs.